Welcome to the Intro to ePM tutorial. Using Internet Explorer, go to the address shown here to access the ePM portal. The ePM portal contains links to all ePM-related applications, reference materials, reports, and guidance. The five links on the left of the portal direct users to the various ePM applications. Please reference the appropriate quick reference guide, video, or training session for more information about a particular application. To access D2D, Data to Decisions Dashboards, click on the upper right link. D2D can enable business analysts and managers to make data-driven decisions based on real-time information and pre-built data queries covering necessary areas. The next link redirects users to the quick reference guides posted on gsa.gov. These guides provide step-by-step instruction on actions that can be performed in each ePM application. The ePM ePM Express Reports link directs users to a Google folder that contains the most recently run ePM reports. For the most current guidance on the data entry requirements for ePM and ePM Express, click on the GSA Guidance link. Note that this link is highlighted a different color because it is the only link that requires the user to be on the GSA network for access. All other links can be accessed from inside or outside the GSA network. For ePM help and access issues, contact the ePM Help Desk at epmsupport@gsa.gov. To access the ePM application, click on the option labeled ePM. When outside of the GSA network, multi-factor authentication is required. With your GSA user ID entered, click Submit to continue to the next step. Select the delivery method for your temporary registration code and click Submit. With your 4-digit registration code entered, click Submit to continue to the next step. The final step of MFA requires your Active Directory password. If you have forgotten your password, you can click on Forget Password in the lower left. Click Submit to continue. Navigating ePM. Based on a user's functional role in ePM, the following workspaces could be available. Organization, accessed by administrators to manage users and project setup. Programs, organized by region and program. Each GSA region has a capital projects program and a small projects program. Accessible by administrators, regional executives, and central office oversight. Projects, provides users with a list of all projects that they have been granted access to. Analytics or advanced reporting. For more information on this workspace, see the Cognos Reporting QRGs by clicking the ePM, ePM Express, Quick Reference Guides link on the ePM portal. Most users will only have access to the project workspace. Click on Projects to go to the list of projects you have been given access to. Find the appropriate project using the following methods. Scroll up or down the list using the scroll wheel on your mouse or the scroll bar on the right side of the browser window. Page forward or backward using the arrows on the upper right of the screen. Change the view of the register. See QRG number 3 for more information. Enter a value in the search box in the upper right and click Find. Once the project has been located, click Enter Project in the row of that project. The project workspace is broken up into 3 areas. The header, which contains the navigation trail that allows users to go back to the project list or home screen. Go to Program button that allows users with proper security to quickly navigate from the project workspace to the program workspace. My Preferences button that allows users to set personal preferences, such as number of items displayed in a register and date and time formats. Reference QRG number 1 for more information on preferences. Help button that contains generic help for the commercial off-the-shelf product that is the platform for EPM. In lieu of the help button, please use the EPM QRGs for help. Log off button that logs the user out of EPM. The menu that contains a list of the applications available to the user. The register that displays a list of documents based on the menu selection that the user has access to. Notices. Notices are generated by workflow and sharing actions in EPM and are associated with an EPM document such as an RFI or invoice. To access notices in the Project Workspace menu, navigate to Notices, My Notices, Receipt. Note that the color of the icon to the left of the number in the register view represents the following. If yellow, you are expected to collaborate on the document. For example, respond to an RFI or approve an invoice. If blue, the document is available for review and you can collaborate if needed. If white, the document was provided for your information and no action is required. In the register, click anywhere in the row to open the document that triggered the notice. The details of the notice will appear on the right of the document. EPM documents. EPM documents are forms in the system that represent the different options in the menu. EPM document options available in the menu are dependent on the user's security. Furthermore, the number of instances of an EPM document will also be limited based on the user's security. For example, a GSA project manager would be able to select executive summary and contracts in the menu and see all instances of those EPM documents. A general contractor would not have access to executive summary option in the menu, and when selecting contracts, would only be able to see the one contract instance that was awarded to them. By navigating to a menu option, such as submittals, a user can open an existing submittal or create a new one depending on their security. To open an existing EPM document, click on any cell in the row of the instance you wish to open. For actions that you can perform on an EPM document, please see the QRG for the appropriate document type. For example, QRG number 14, Submittal Document Creation. If the user has the security required to create a new instance of an EPM document type, then the New button will be available in the Register toolbar. If the button is grayed out, then the user does not have the proper security. A down arrow displayed to the right of the new button represents that different forms exist for the EPM document. Clicking the arrow will display the available forms.